Ryan International Group of Institutions always seeks to encourage their students to explore and express their creative talents. It was no surprise then that the season 2 of the contest, I Want to Be an Author, was officially launched at Ryan International School in Mumbai. Spearheading this session were head of the Right Place, the publishing arm of Crossword Bookstores, Mr. Anoop Jerajani, the Deputy Director, MU and Head, Chanakya International Institute of Leadership Studies and best-selling author, Dr. Radhakrishnan Pillai, young author Vinayak Mittal and our very own CEO, Ryan Sir. Each of the panelists guided and motivated us, breaking down what seemed to be an insurmountable task into doable bits.
Welcome you all to the next season of I Want to Be an Author contest. And I'm sure Ryan International, this branch, as well as across Bombay and other cities, will shine out and will have maximum stories of your students in the book.
I remember the first time I was called in my own school, and on the same day, I come from a school called Vani Vidyalaya in Mulund. So my principal invited me, and we had the principal from Ryan International coming and saying, can you do a book reading session for the children? I'm so glad that you are creating a culture of reading and writing. Writing is very important, because when I was your age, when I was in school, I read a very famous statement. I don't know who made it, but it said very nicely, reading makes a man, and writing makes him a complete man.
I'm Vinayak Mittal, I'm 16 years old, and I'm the author of these two books, Crossroads and Cross Chimes. No matter how many rejections you get, no matter what anyone says to you, just do what you really want to do, what comes from within you. Because if you have really decided on something, that you really love this, no matter what anyone says, you'll succeed in that thing.
Reading not only just helps you relax, but it also helps you to refocus. And that's very important in life, because time management is very, very important as you grow up. So I really encourage you, continue down that road to read and to learn, and also to participate in this competition of I Want to Be an Author.
And of course, we took full advantage of their patience and mentorship by clearing all our doubts. Needless to say, we were highly motivated. After all, if young author Vinayak Mittal can write a book during the year of his board exams, so can we. So immediately after the launch, we YJs spoke to Anoop Sir to get the contest details.
I Want to Be an Author Season 2, it's a contest for all the school children in Bombay and Bangalore in the standard, between the standard 5th and 10th. It's a short story competition where students can send their short stories in the words. The short story has to be between 800 and 1200 words. And once we receive all the entries, we will judge the entries, and the best 30 to 40 entries will be published under a publishing initiative, which is called The Right Place. And we'll felicitate those authors whose entries are selected. This is the second year. Last year we published 39 stories into a book. It was called Young Storytellers, and this also will be called Young Storytellers Season 2. And it is our way of encouraging the young and budding authors to one day become successful authors and successful in whatever field they want to be. We are here to build confidence in them.
We also spoke to Dr. Radhakrishnan Pillai on technology and young readers. Sir, today's generation is much involved in technology, and reading has become an old thing. So how would you like students to pick up reading? What message would you like to give them so that they encourage themselves to read?
So first of all, I don't think technology is bad. Technology is very good. It gives you access to information at the speed of thought. The challenge here is not reading, but it's actually reading the paper. So I'm sure many of your generation have already started reading the electronic versions of books, Kindles and whatever, you know, e-copies and e-books. But the whole joy of reading a physical book is what we need to cultivate. So I would say technology can be there, but can you balance it with the hard copies?
The whole idea is that if we can have a 50-50% balance. So I would suggest that if you're reading things on the mobile or any particular device, that's fine. But maybe at the end of the day, if you can reach maybe 50 pages or 10 pages or 5 pages every day. And what happens is that touch and feel has got a psychological impact. So what you look on the screen, it's very distractive, especially with, you know, you go to one thing and then the other thing pops up. So attention span is very less. In the physical book space, what exactly happens is that your mind will come back to that thing. It imagines, but it comes back. It is less destructive and less distractive also. So encourage, and I'm sure if you're going to balance both, you'll be great readers.
So we just finished with the interactive session. So how did you find the students? Were they readers? Were they writers? How exactly?
So some of them are already writers. So we had a published author. We have people who want to be published. But the interesting part is that I think my particular view is that at least start reading. And if you're encouraging students to read, I think they are, because the questions that came even from you and everybody else were so out of the box. I never imagined a school child actually asking these questions, because if I were in your age group many years ago, maybe a generation ago, I wouldn't be asking these questions. So I'm glad that you're actually thinking higher than what probably our age group was.
The next question in your minds must be, how can we begin?
What message or how would you like to inspire the writers of your age to start their first write-up?
So the main thing for writing, I think, is you need to read a lot. So first, I'd like to tell them, read as many books as you can. Read books of any category. Read fiction, read non-fiction, read science, whatever you can, because every book teaches you something. So from each book, you get to learn something and use that as a catalyst for writing your first book. And writing your first book is actually the toughest thing. The first book is the hardest. So you just need to remember that if you are having writer's block or something like that, you keep on writing. Let the write whatever you can from whatever you have thought. So, and if it doesn't turn out to be good, next day erase that and start writing again. You just need that flow, and don't give up on your dreams. If you really like writing, keep on writing, and because if you follow your dreams, what cannot be achieved.
Fantastic opportunity. All you need is some time and a lot of imagination. On that note, this is YJ Aman with YJ Shivani signing off for Ryan TV.